Hi, my name is Lorna Mothania Ochido, and I'm making it one of my life's mission to demystify the speech therapy field and to empower more parents on what they can start to do in order to optimize their child's communication outcomes. So whether you want your child to talk more or talk better, learn better, and overall optimize their potential. So stay tuned and feel free to send in any topics on speech and language development you'd like for me to tackle. In today's What Is series, I am going to tackle the question of what does a pediatric neurologist do? So a pediatric neurologist is a doctor who treats children who have or are suspected to have issues with their nervous system. So what is the nervous system? Well, a very basic biology class. The nervous system has two main parts. The central nervous system, which is made up of the brain and the spinal cord, and the peripheral nervous system, which is made up of the nerves that come off from the spinal cord and extend to all the parts of the body. And what is the function of the nervous system? Well, pretty much everything. The central nervous system has many functions that take place with or without your control. So like your heartbeat, it beats whether you're conscious that it's beating or not. And that's because such automatic body functions are controlled by the autonomic system, but actions like walking and talking and clapping require voluntary action and are controlled by something called the somatic nerves. Then there are the sympathetic nerves that get you geared up for fight or flight reaction, and the associated body reactions such as heart quickening, sweating, butterflies in your stomach, and these are brought back to normal functioning by the parasympathetic nerves. So get your heart rate back to resting position and whatnot. And let's not forget the brain, which pretty much controls everything. So various parts of the brain are responsible for various functions. There's the left side of the brain, so the left hemisphere, that is responsible for speech, language, and general learning. And the right side of the brain, or the right hemisphere, that controls emotions, artistic expression, music, etc. Then there's the cerebellum, which controls complex movements and posture and balance and coordination and muscle learning, etc. And it gets more exciting. I am actually quite fascinated with the workings of the nervous system, you know, the brain, and down to the level of the atoms. But let's not digress. So a pediatric neurologist's work is to review children who are presenting with any kind of developmental delay as a result of a known etiology or cause, or something more unknown or idiopathic, so that they can try to get to the bottom of. So they're trying to review and see what is causing the delay. Pediatric neurologists often assess, diagnose, and treat children who are presenting with the following conditions. So seizures, convulsions, behavioral issues like hyperactivity, attention deficit disorder, developmental disorders such as cerebral palsy, delayed speech and language, delayed motor milestones, so they didn't hold their neck up on time, they didn't sit on time, they're probably not walking on time, autism, congenital malformations and syndromes, infections or inflammations of the brain or the spinal cord like meningitis. So a pediatric neurologist may order the following assessments or tests. They can order an EEG, which stands for electroencephalogram. Did I say that right? Electroencephalogram. Yeah, that one. It's a test that looks for abnormal electrical activity in your brain. And this test can be used to look for seizures. They can also order an MRI, which stands for magnetic resonance imaging, or a CT scan, which are types of imaging tests that take pictures of the brain and or the spine. So these can look for signs of disease like tumors, infections, as well as certain genetic conditions. They can also order a lumbar puncture, which is a spinal tap. So it's a test where doctors insert a small needle into the lower back of the spine to take a sample of the spinal fluid, which surrounds your brain and spinal cord, so the fluid. And this can help look for signs for infection or inflammation. This is the test that is used to diagnose meningitis. Pediatric neurologists can also order for blood tests. The test can confirm signs of infection, but the neurologist can also order blood tests for more complicated testing, such as genetic tests or specific disorders. So to rule the presence of, say, Down syndrome or not. And of course, pediatric neurologists do prescribe medications like anticonvulsants, hyperactivity reducing drugs, etc. Pediatric neurologists work closely with speech therapists and occupational therapists, as well as physical therapists or physiotherapists, to optimize motorical and communication outcomes for children. So the work of the pediatric neurologist is to diagnose, but they do not offer physical therapy. That's the work of a speech therapist and occupational therapist and PTs. Pharmacological management may be recommended by a pediatric neurologist, but your child would still need to be managed by the relevant therapist if your child is displaying, you know, speech, language, or motor delays. In Kenya, I have also encountered other professions that are similar to pediatric neurologists, such as the neurodevelopmental specialists or developmental pediatricians. Now, my opinion is that these two other professionals do the same work or similar work to that of the pediatric neurologist. But my advice is, if you find yourself in the situation where you refer to either a developmental pediatrician or a neurodevelopmental specialist, just find out from them about their role in specifically managing your child's presentation. So ask the right questions. Are you going to give a diagnosis? What is the importance of the diagnosis? And really, in my opinion, a diagnosis in Kenya isn't as important as the identification of the symptoms and then managing those symptoms. So to conclude, word of advice, when you visit a pediatric neurologist, make sure you have listed down all the issues you have seen in your child in order for the pediatric neurologist to quickly get acquainted with your child's situation and formulate an assessment path or a management plan for your child. If, for example, you're concerned that your child may be having a seizure or a stutter or another kind of disruptive motor activity, list the symptoms you have seen, because when you're in the doctor's office, describing under time pressure is not something that you think you might feel comfortable doing. Then you could always rely on what you have written down. So these, what you write down, are essentially just observations over time, like when the symptom is worse, when it's better, how your child presents in different situations. It's the same with when you take your child to a GP or a pediatrician. The more information you give the GP, the better equipped they are to make the best clinical judgments. And I mean, remember, they're just humans. So equip them, give them as much information as you possibly can for them to order the right test or the necessary test. As always, I hope this series has shed some light about what pediatric neurologists do. Feel free to check out our other series if this particular topic has raised something new for you or you'd like to be in the know with the other speech therapy related topics. Thank you so much.